New technology. New tire and suspension technology can cover up and allow riders to get away with basic riding errors. Going canyon riding and track racing in the 1990s is an interesting situation for someone who started riding motorcycles in 1957. Old traction memories and standards die hard, and I'm not that brave. The 1990s rubber has nearly unbelievable grip in comparison to what I last raced on in the 70s, but out on the track, I see this as a problem for new hotshot riders coming up, and I'm continually amazed at how fast some of them go without a clue as to how and why. Doug, getting the exit traction right every time is easier and helps with the straights. Traction riders. All of the things that arise from this are very interesting. Riders who rely solely on their perception of maximum traction have a certain style they develop. They appear to be lost if they can't feel that particular band of traction and don't believe they're going fast unless they do feel that traction. Here are some of the results. 1. Feeling their way into turns. Too slow turn-in rate. Chandler. A new approach to the turn could give you a whole new view of traction. Just don't try too many things at once. 2. Low entries. Start turn-in too early. 3. Mid-turn steering corrections. Slow turn-in makes the final result uncertain until mid-turn. 4. Too much lean angle. From slow turn-in and from an attempt to get the tire load up so they can feel it. 5. Greedy mid-turn throttle application. To feel the tire bite. 6. Excessive wheel spin at exit. To keep it loose to know where the traction is. Usually, but not always, a plus point. 7. Changing turn points. Their object is not to get the bike turned accurately, but to bring the traction to their range. 8. Suspension set too stiff, also to feel the traction better. There most probably are additional possible negative results. Doug, easing off, not charging, gets better lap times. You usually get better entry speeds not charging. The hardest part is finding the grip limit going in. The easiest is on the exit. Smart traction. Don't get me wrong, finding the traction limits of the new rubber is an accomplishment. How you find it and then use it is our topic. Look at it this way. If maximum tire grip is your major target for a turn, it will govern how you ride. Any line which gets a traction rider to a point where his tires give back this grunt and bite feeling against the pavement will be a good line. But it isn't true. At least not for all turns, and if it gets out of hand, it can add the above 8 errors to the rider's portfolio of techniques. Doug, try to explore different lines, lean angles, and apexes, not just be stuck on one line. I remember Wayne Rainey in 1986 and 87 spending an enormous amount of his time at the races trying to figure out how to make a fast first lap, and it was a battle fought totally with traction. Is it any wonder that he led so many first laps in his world championship winning years, 90, 91, and 92? In 1986 and 87, he was making all of the above 8 errors in search of the traction limits. Is it a crime to make those errors? No. Look at what he did with them. The point is that it isn't the only way to go about it. Eddie Lawson did it without the extra excitement. Doug, the really hard part is finding the limit every turn, every lap. Traction terror. The lion's share of survival reactions connected to traction are at the turn entries. We know that the very definition of going in too fast is not sure if you can get it turned. And while running wide in the turns is a concern, possible loss of traction ranks high on the list of SR triggers. Is this true for you too? Once in the turn, your throttle action controls traction. But right at the beginning, you're essentially at the mercy of the speed you have when the brakes are released. Doug says, too much entry speed can also foul you up if you go offline. Crash statistics. Factually, it's uncommon to go into a turn too fast. Watch racing for 20 or 30 years and tell me what you observe. My eyes tell me going in too fast is low on the scale of crash causes. It is rare. Going in with the brakes on too hard and crashing is another thing. That causes crashes fairly often and is an obvious rider error. That most riders misjudge their turn entry speed, usually on the slow side, is a major stumbling block to clean and quick turn execution.